Hi, Jason with Tormach. Do you like my hat? I had the opportunity to make this from a 56-pound billet. I was super excited to do this project. I really enjoy making parts like this. They present some really great challenges and they're just fun to make. Holding an organic shape like this can be rather complicated. The head has a 40-thousandths wall thickness, so you really want to support the entire surface for stability while you're cutting it. This is why we chose to use superglue for the work holding. I only needed to make two parts, so building a vacuum fixture or another complicated work holding method was really just outside of the scope for this project. So we used the superglue in conjunction with painter's tape to see if it would work for a large organic shape. I've used superglue on parts like this in the past with really good success. But removing the part from the fixture and cleaning everything up can be a little more difficult without using painter's tape with it. So it really was a good opportunity for us to test the superglue with the painter's tape, so just test everything all out and learn something new in the process. So for the fixture, we ran a small little test bar to see how this process would work using a curved shape before we actually cut the part. It's always good practice just to prove out a theory before you try it out on a very large, expensive part. We did a separate video on this, and the results of it looked really promising. So we're pretty comfortable moving forward with this strategy for use with the hat itself. The fixture was cut 20-thousandths undersized to allow space for the glue and the tape. An important aspect when you're plunge roughing is how you're gonna manage the tool engagement. We used the 1-inch shear hog with a 5-inch arbor on this for all the roughing strategies. This tool can't handle a full diameter plunge. Fruit cam gives us the ability to create the tool path that only cuts going in the uphill direction or on a flat surface, and it just does this automatically. So we're able to create a couple of roughing paths that started from different directions and kind of approached the part from a couple different angles, and we were able to successfully and very quickly rough out this part using that plunge roughing strategy. For finishing, we use a 9mm diameter button cutter, and this uses 5mm inserts and is great for parts like this. It gives you a better surface finish than you can achieve with a ball end mill since you're not cutting on the center line of the tool, but it still has a nice large radius with that 5mm insert to be able to effectively finish the part. So let's jump to the hat itself. We cut the inside as Op1 and we did this on a 770M. This was really a quite simple operation. Take everything out of the inside and make it look amazing with a finish pass. Sounds simple, right? The main consideration for this op was to roll the outside edge. The radius of the hat here, as you can see, this is something that I wouldn't be able to machine from the second op because it's an undercut. So I wanted to be able to roll this edge so that I have a nice smooth radius and deburred and everything right off the machine. So to accomplish this, when we created the model, I had the whole block and everything modeled into it. So the block was actually sitting a little bit more than the radius of my tool below the edge of the hat. So this allowed me to very quickly and efficiently program Op1 without having to come in and try to control my tool path on a curved shape. It just made the management and tool pathing and everything very simple. For the second operation, this is where everything got to be a little more fun. This is where the nerves come in. It's like the first side went pretty well, everything went well, tool paths ran great. Second op, now it's kind of like this crazy idea actually us all to come together. The good news was the part and the fixture fit together beautifully. We set the hat on there. Everything just fit nice, it located great. We measured up the stack heights and everything was within a couple of thousandths of what we expected to see. So everything, we were very happy with the results of that. The not so fun part was getting it ready to put on the fixture. Taping this thing up was a very slow process. The fixture wasn't too bad to do. Since I wasn't really concerned about scratching the part, I was able just to lay tape over the entire fixture. And then I'd come back with a razor blade and just trim off the overlap. And that went pretty quick. But obviously that wouldn't work for the hat itself since scratching the inside wasn't an option. So I ended up cutting little strips of tape and fitting them in there, and it just ended up being a very tedious process. It ended up working out pretty well in the end, but definitely a time-consuming part of the process for us. The thought process on this part for both operations were use a single tool and don't worry about it moving or breaking anything. I only had a couple parts to make, so cycle time wasn't really a consideration. The only way I really thought about it was, is this going to be finished when I get back to the shop in the morning? Was my only consideration with cycle times. So for the roughing strategies and stuff, we used a 2-flute mini shear, 3/4-inch diameter on the long arbor. We did some real light depths of cut and we just roughed this whole thing out with a single tool, light depths of cut, just to get some material off of it and just to not worry about any process reliability. For finishing, we used the same 9mm button cutter that we used on Op1. And when we started cutting and finishing on the second operation, that's where we started to learn those important lessons. So we were about a third of the way through the first hat we had to make on the finishing pass, and we started to get some chatter in the cut. We tried adjusting speeds and feeds and everything, and we were able to get it better, but it was still visible on the surface finish of the part. So we let it finish up just to get it done. We're looking at it, and I was debating whether or not I wanted to recut this. With the wall thickness already being 40 thousandths thick, I had some real reservations. It seemed like kind of risky to try to recut this part again. So we went ahead and removed it from the fixture. This came off a lot easier than I expected. It's a big area, lots of super glue in there. I kind of thought it'd come off rather difficult, but this came off pretty easy, which was a nice benefit. It slid right off, everything came off without damaging the part. But this is also where I learned that painter's tape wicks up moisture. I had a small datum hole in the top of the fixture, and it was full of coolant. So the adhesive on the tape failed, and the only thing actually holding the hat to the fixture anymore was the brim itself. So in hindsight, I was quite happy that it looked as good as it did, that it didn't come off the fixture or lift it up and actually like destroy the part on us. But it was definitely a nice learning moment. Everything ended up looking really nice on the first hat. We have a mold maker on staff, on our technical team, and she felt right at home grabbing that hat, polishing that thing to a near mirror finish, and it ended up looking really beautiful when it was done. So for the second hat, we knew we definitely had to make some adjustments, but what options do we really have? The inside of the hat was already machined, the fixture is already done, I don't have any more material to remake the fixture, you know, so we were kind of married and stuck with the process that we were using. So sticking with the whole KISS principle for engineering, the simple answer was to just seal the bottom edge of the hat. I used some putty to seal up the base. Putty was only a few dollars, and the machine just cut right through all the excess that was sticking out from the side of the hat and everything. It ended up working really well. So we pulled off the second hat off the fixture. The tape was completely dry. It came off quite a bit harder, but still using the heat gun, we were able to just heat the whole hat to about 90 to 100 degrees and just very gently pry it off with a little piece of wood. And everything came off really nice. As you can see, the surface finish on the second hat looked really good. We were really happy with how this whole project turned out. It was, again, just a great experience and a great opportunity for us to be able to make something fun and to share it with a coworker. So I hope you enjoyed this project as much as we did, and I hope you learned something along the way. Thanks for watching.